There is a line in that song that says, the porcupine talks to himself. And that actually came out of a camping trip that I took about 5 or 6 years ago now up into the southwestern part of Montana. I was camping with my wife on a place called the Tobacco Root Mountains in southwestern Montana. We were up about 9,500 feet. And we were there for about a week and a half, and we hadn't seen another living soul up there. Now, you have to realize that when it gets dark in Montana up in the mountains, there are no kinds of cities around to give you any kind of reflective lighting at all, and the moon didn't happen to be out at that time of month. So when it got dark, it got dark. So one morning, my wife says to me, did you hear a very strange noise in the camp last night? And I said, no. She said, there was a presence in this camp making some strange noises last night. And I thought, fine, let's go home. Because I am no Daniel Boone in the woods. So the next morning, 3:30 in the morning, it's just as black as can be. Can't even see your hand in front of your face. I am lying awake, staring at the roof of the tent, listening to the wind in the passes. And I hear this. And I'm staring at the roof of the tent. And thinking, it's just the wind. But it's getting closer and closer and closer. And this thing brushed right by my head, right along the wall of the tent. And I thought to myself, oh man, they've landed. I figured we're all gonna wake up on Pluto. See the blue light start to flash, and then that was gonna be the end of the whole thing. So I gathered all my courage together, took my flashlight, zipped down the opening of the tent about half an inch. Making as little sound as possible, I turned on the flashlight, shined my light out, got this big old porcupine messing around in the fire, got him right between the eyes with my flashlight beam. He's just scared the daylights out of him, it did. He's kind of a crotchety old fella, got caught right there in my campfire. Anyhow, that's where that line comes from.